welcome to Andorra Guides. Today my guest and my guide is going to be Anton Adena, a graphic designer, owner of a digital agency who has just released a really cool app called Montpackers. Hello.
Hey Sandra.
Hi Anton, how are you?
Good, good. You?
Good. Take the seatbelt, please. Are you ready to go?
Yes.
Anton, you come from Reus in Spain, and this is a town quite well known to people from Andorra. They quite often have their holiday houses there because it's quite close to Andorra, but it's at the coast. What brought you here from the sea surroundings to the mountains?
Yeah, good question. So by the time I was in London, and a friend of mine invited me to come to Andorra, so...
Have you known Andorra? Have you been coming here as a child or...?
Yeah, so when I... for us it's quite like common because it's the quickest, like also like for Andorran people to go to the coast is the quickest way to go mm-hmm. in Reus or nearby. So for us also, if you want to go for skiing, Andorra is super close for the big ski resorts or like also for shopping mm-hmm. based on the past. So yeah, I already know Andorra and everything, but I didn't know the mountains or everything you can do here. Mm-hmm.
And you said that you moved here from London, so you were living in London, you were working there for big companies, and then you moved to Andorra with the thought of building your own business, or...?
Yeah, I always wanted to have my business, so when I moved here, that was the intention also for the benefits of the country. Mm-hmm.
Me moving to Andorra from Poland, it has not been the easiest process. It took a lot of time to adjust. You're Spanish, or Catalan, I should say, so you speak all the languages. Has it been a smooth process for you, or did you have any difficulties?
Yeah, so for me, being Andorra, it's like being at home, so I have no problem, and I can like interact and speak with everyone with my tongue language. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's like, yeah, as I said, being at home.
Is the culture similar as well?
Yeah, everything, culture, food.
Talking about your latest project, an app, Montpackers, that has launched last week. What is Montpackers? Who are Montpackers?
Yeah, so who are Montpackers? That's a good question. Basically, everyone who goes to the mountain need a backpack. Mm-hmm. So a mountpacker is the backpacker of the mountain. So you mm-hmm. cannot go to the mountain without your backpack, because you have to wear like your food, water, spare clothing, safety gear. Mm-hmm. So if you are like professional or amateur skier, or like you are doing any type of sports, you need a backpack mm-hmm. to go to the mountain. So that's why everyone who goes to the mountain is a mountpacker.
And why the app? Where is the idea coming from? Why did you decide to come up with an app for Andorra?
So when I moved here, like, I didn't know anyone. I didn't know places to go apart the ski resort. And I found a lack of information. So, and I found it like super interesting, because before you go to the mountain, it's super important that you check meteor, you check avalanche, mm-hmm. you check webcams, road conditions, everything. So it was too like misorganized, and you have to go to different places to check everything. Mm-hmm. A tourist who comes to Andorra, they even have like a bigger problem, because they don't know where to go. Mm-hmm. They don't know restaurants, for example. They don't know like local places that when you live here you end up knowing. Mm-hmm. So it's for tourists who come to Andorra, but also like a tool for local people mm-hmm. for every day.
So what problems exactly is the app solving? Which features do you have?
We have weather. You can find, like, when you open the app, you will find like different towns or different sports.
Yeah, this is something that I find really useful. So you can find all the towns in Andorra, as well as the ski resorts that are higher up. So you can, sometimes you are living in a town and you think like, oh, it's not so cold or it's not snowing, but actually at the ski resort it is. So that's a really good function.
Yeah, some ski resorts are in the towns. Mm-hmm. That's why like it's very important to added here also, like for tourists, their hotels or like are in the towns. So that's why we have a list. And then you can see for now the weather, the temperature, and then the altitude.
And if you check the weather and you're still not sure whether to go skiing or walking in the mountains, you can go and check the cameras as well.
Yes, so we have another tab where you can see the road cameras.
Can you show it to the camera just to give?
For example, here, the road cameras organized by the border to the top. So we curate all of them. And also you have the slopes, so you can see if it is snowing or not. So where are we going now?
Arinsal.
So see, for example, in Arinsal it is snowing, but actually here where we are is not snowing. So that's why it's super useful when you are at home in the morning, you open the app, and then you can see the weather or if it's snowing in the ski resort or
not. And let's not forget about the tourists that come here from Spain and France by car. Of course, when they want to leave or enter Andorra, it's quite important to check the traffic on the border, so you're not stuck on the border for a very long time. And yes, that's also possible.
Sure, that's also possible, and that's why we put like the first camera for on the road, you see, it's the border. So then you can see how many cars, and you can follow the journey.
Perfect. And one more thing that you mentioned, going to the mountains by yourself without the knowledge is very dangerous. That's why you have a feature of avalanches.
Yes, so one of them is avalanche. That was a problem that they had, like, okay, you want to do like ski mountaineering or just trekking or hiking with your family, then you end up going always to the same places. So what's the way to discover new places? We track different tracks and we put them like inside the app, just like for people to discover new places to go.
Let's mention as well, it's not only an app dedicated for people who come here skiing, but people who come here all year around, so people who want to hike as well as mountain bike. For these purposes, you also been working on presenting a point of interest.
Our idea was to follow the journey. So you wake up, you check meteo, weather, webcams. Then what are you doing? You go to the mountain. So you open tracks, you discover a new track. So you do your like day in the mountains, following the app. But what are you doing after? You normally go to the restaurant or you go for shopping. That's why we have points of interest. So it's our curation list of places where you can go after your day in the mountains.
Many people, especially tourists who come here, you know, they don't have the data and the roaming is very expensive. Is it possible to download some of these features and use it offline?
Yeah, so mostly all of the app is works offline. So of course you need some internet, but you can load the app with Wi-Fi and then it stays for a long time and you can like leave and continue using the app without internet. Also, when you are in the mountains, normally you don't have internet also for local people.
Yeah, that's true.
So that's why we wanted to build an app that solve this problem.
And this is the first version of, of the app. You've been working on it for a very long time, but I understand that you're still working and you have some other ideas. What can we expect in the future from Mountpackers?
So we want to improve the tracking screen or feature, being more easy to use, and also the navigation. Of course, weather will change, adding like more custom screens for users, creating users, so you will have like creative content only for you, all you need.
Are you thinking as well to the points of interest, maybe to direct them to a specific groups, like people interested in sports or families with kids?
Yeah, so we are gonna add filters, so you can filter by nearby, by families, in that case the tracks level of skiing.
Yeah, that sounds really really great, and I really appreciate that you as an expat come to Andorra and decide to give something to Andorra. it shows that, you know, you really have to like the place, I guess.
Yes, I love it.
How is your working day? What's the lifestyle of living and working in Andorra in your business, in IT business?
Well, it's the best lifestyle you can have, I think. Normally, you wake up, or in that case, I wake up and I check the weather
on Montpackers.
On Montpackers. If it's snowing, not nowadays with the COVID, but if it's snowing, of course, like that night I cannot sleep because I'm thinking on the next day in the mountains, just like enjoying the powder. So I go to the mountains, I just ski for like 2 hours or mm-hmm. three, and then like I go to the office and I have the full day working in the office. So
what do you do in the summer when it's not snowing?
Cycling.
Yeah.
Trekking. You can do a lot of peaks in Andorra. Yeah. You can go to the lake, so you don't need the sea.
And this year you also took up a new hobby. You're riding a trials bike.
Yeah, and trials. So that's super interesting because in Spain you cannot ride trials on the mountain. And the way to discover new tracks is with a motorbike. Mm-hmm. So you can...
Are you doing it alone or did you find... group of people that you can share this experience with?
Always, you have to go to the mountain always with people because if you are in trouble, they will help you mm-hmm. for sure. So yeah, we have a nice group of friends who all of us, we start doing trials this year, so we went for it.
How do you socialize in Andorra? How did you find these people? Is it everyone related to the business, the work you do, or how does it work here?
Andorran people, they are more close, so they are not open. It's, I found it hard to like meet with them. Mm-hmm. And for me, as I'm an expat, I found like a nice community of expats where like you can speak English. Like my English not so good, but anyway,
no,
I can. Yeah, like there is people like me who are on the same interest, they found same problems or they are in the same situation, so mm-hmm. everyone is like super open and they help you on everything you need, also for plans and go to the mountain.
And to sum up, Andorra is advertising itself as a place really good for online businesses. Do you see this market growing?
Yeah, definitely. So there is still some things to fix in Andorra, because for some big companies, Andorra is not in the map. Mm-hmm. But of course, like if you can combine your lifestyle with your online work, then I think Andorra is the perfect spot because you are in also in the middle of Europe, kind of. You have like sun, good weather, temperature, so.
And very quick internet.
Yeah, and very quick internet.
All right, we arrived. We are in top of Arinsal and we can go out and check out the view on the valley. As you said, yeah. It is snowing in Arinsal.
And sunny.
Yes.
Both.